Hi singers, it's Mickey here, and I wanted to make a follow-up video to the video that I posted on Monday about vibrato, because apparently it has generated some controversy, and that was definitely not my intention. On YouTube, there haven't been that many comments back and forth. I did get as many thumbs down on this video as thumbs up, which has not happened to me before, but there weren't that many comments. But on Reddit, I am part of a group called Singers, which is a subreddit, and there was a lot of back and forth on this topic. And some people are saying that I had contributed to misinformation or confusion, and so I definitely wanted to set the record straight and clarify my points so that I'm not confusing anybody, because that is not my intention. As you know, I make these videos just to help people, and I don't make money off of these videos. It's something that I do to try and assist people that are trying to work on their technique and can't afford to go to a singing coach. So the first things that I want to do are just dispel a few tangential misconceptions. And number one is, I am not speaking about vibrato in the classical sense. I am not a classically trained opera singer. And from what I understand from the comments back and forth, vibrato in classical opera singing is something completely different than vibrato in the pop realm. So I do not pretend to be trained in this area. I would not want to speak on classical singing because I don't want to give anybody misinformation. Number two is, I do not think vibrato is necessary for you to sound professional or to have a beautiful voice. I think I said something in my video that might have been misconstrued in that direction, but obviously if you sing with a straight tone, you can have a beautiful tone, you can have a beautiful voice, you can sound professional. Vibrato is not necessary. I just think it's another skill that you can have in your tool belt that you can choose to employ when you think that it enhances your performance. So those are kind of two tangential side points that I wanted to bring up. The main controversy, from what I can tell, is that there is this question of whether vibrato is naturally occurring or it is something that can be consciously simulated. First of all, I don't think that it's either or. I think that both can be true. And I also want to just semantically look at what it means to have a natural vibrato, because I think that there's some overlap in the two viewpoints, and we're just kind of using natural in a different way. Number one, I kind of had looked at a lot of other vocal coaches' videos on vibrato before I made my own, and I found them personally very confusing, and I saw a lot of comments on those videos in the discussion section saying that it was confusing and that they thought that the explanation was incorrect and going back and forth, similar to what happened on my video. So it seems as if there is not like one quintessential explanation of what vibrato means to everyone. I was hoping to provide a little bit more clarity. Obviously, I didn't do that great a job on it. I apologize for that, but I'm a flawed person and I'm not gonna, you know, hit the ball out of the park every single time. But, you know, coming back to this idea of natural versus conscious, there are a lot of people who say that vibrato is a side effect of natural, relaxed singing, and that when you relax your throat in a certain way, that vibrato just occurs. This has not been my experience. And from the students that I've taught over the years, and this has been many, many students, I have not had that phenomenon reported. I don't know if this is true in the classical realm and not in the pop realm. I don't know, I don't teach classical singers, but I find that if I relax to the point where my voice is oscillating, that it's due to a lack of breath support. And that when I'm properly supported and I'm singing naturally, I have a straight tone. That being said, when I make the conscious decision to initiate my vibrato, it's like shifting into a certain gear. And once my vibrato is initiated, I don't consciously oscillate the pitch of my voice. And I think it would be very difficult to have that kind of precise control where you could oscillate the pitch so quickly and so evenly that it would sound good in vibrato. Maybe you could have a very loose and wide vibrato and manage to do that, but You know, when you're producing a healthy and beautiful sounding vibrato, it has to be something that is almost occurring involuntarily. So for me, vibrato is a conscious gear that I have to shift into, but once I engage that gear, it happens involuntarily. So hopefully that's a little bit more clear. There was also a really interesting philosophical discussion on the subreddit, which I thought I would mention, and that was with regards to what it means to have a naturally occurring ability. And the person that posed this discussion was basically saying that yes, we might have certain physical limitations or certain physical attributes that others might not possess that give us the potential to have these natural talents, but it always takes development and practice and honing your technique. And if you start to study technique at a very young age, these things become so second nature over time that you may not even remember what it felt like not to have this ability. And that might make it seem like it's this natural ability. I agree with this for the most part. Again, it's kind of semantics, so it's hard to say exactly whether we're thinking about and conceptualizing these things the exact same way. But I do think that a lot of it is training. There are some natural predispositions that you might have. For example, if you are very tall and you have certain fast twitch muscle fibers, you're going to be better at running than somebody that's short and doesn't possess those. And the same is true in singing. You might have certain abilities that are naturally present in a greater amount than another person. But if you don't work on them and you don't hone them, it's going to be very rare that you're going to be good at something. And so I think in that sense, it is true. And for me, I think this is true because I cannot remember a time when I didn't know how to produce vibrato. Because I think I was experimenting with my voice at such an early age and I was studying piano, my knowledge of, you know, learning this skill is lost in the sands of time. It kind of seems like it just appeared. So in that sense, I guess it is kind of a natural ability, but again, I have to make the conscious decision to begin to initiate that vibrato. And this seems to align with my students' perceptions. The video that I made on Monday was for a student of mine that had never experienced producing a vibrato. And so I made the video for her, and I found that that exercise of pumping the gas and artificially creating a sensation similar to vibrato helped her kind of back into getting that sensation. So that's why I made the video. I hope that this cleared a few things up. I'm very happy to engage in a back and forth with you. And I will say that even though there was some controversy surrounding this on Reddit, the discussion remained very civil and people were very, very nice, which I appreciated. The other thing that I want to just quickly touch upon that I didn't talk about in my video is obviously there's a lot of different types of vibrato and not everybody's vibrato is going to sound the same. And I think this is especially true in contemporary music. You can have a very loose and wide vibrato, you can have a very tight, quick vibrato, and that really depends on your voice and your training. I'll put a little example up at the end of this video of one of my favorite vibratos, which is Melora Krieger from the band Rasputina. That, to me, does not sound like it's something that just is a natural side effect of her relaxing her voice. I'm looking forward to hearing your comments on this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I will be back next Monday for another singing tip of the week. Until then, happy singing. Okay.